a slender white shadow towering. Someone stands there, raising her pistol at him. The lieutenant does not see it. He's pushing down on your wound with both hands. Authority. Very high. Plus one for lieutenant trusts you, and plus two for Kim truly trusts you. No! Kim! No, you say, and hand out your firearm to him. Your hand trembles, and your eyes are full of fear, authority says. That's all it takes. There is no room for hesitation. The lieutenant moves like a spring unloaded. He grabs the gun from your bloody hand and fires behind him. You hear a faint scream, a woman's. Then the sound disappears, like someone pressed stop on the tape. The woman is gone. So is Kim. Then the whole world fall into total darkness.
This is death. One more door, baby. One more door.
I have the sound off. Okay. Guess it's fitting in this case. We can't hear it. Will I be a ghost now?
Brava. You already were a ghost. Up there, screaming along with all of them. Scaring each other. Haunting each other. It's the living who are ghosts. The dead are silent. They don't rattle windows or write letters in blood. The living do. Leave them behind. Rest.
No. Let me back into the fight.
The fight? There is no fight. The fight is over. It was lost 1,000 years ago. You have laid here forever. Keep falling. Take the door. He's not taking it. His body is not taking it. Oh, God, no. He's not disintegrating. He's swelling up instead. Over the hours, hurting, moaning in his sleep.
Does that mean he's not dying?
And rotting. And being disinfected, and smelling of drugs, and feeling saliva in his mouth. Drifting in painkillers, thrashing in his wound sleep.
Volition says he can't go, not before the case is solved. Perception hearing says there is a radio in the distance, a radio of the world, playing sounds. Good morning, Elysium. Soon you will return to the world.
Hours turn to days. Soon we will get up again and go through it again, again. Finally we know what the infernal engine was outside. The clarion call.
Encyclopedia says the engine of a Capri Kinema.
No, it was him. He is the infernal engine. Can't you see? He never stops. He only gets worse.
Wow. So we're going to be... We're having medication and stuff. Are we in the hospital? Being disinfectant, drugs, painkillers... So I'm unconscious, or Harry's unconscious in the hospital, and he's gonna get up. But does he even have legs? The whole half of his body was gone. You see Kim's familiar shape in the orange jacket. He has legs. It turns double, then triple, from the pain. Kim. Sunrise, Parabellum, the lieutenant says. He's in the middle of a freshly cleaned room, with the fan above his head like a halo. His face is covered in bruises. What happened? What happened? You shot the Major in the face. A firefight ensued. Is he dead? Yes. Inland Empire says, a bloodstained killer. I'm a killer. You're an officer of the RCM, he continues without waiting for a reply. As retaliation, their rifleman shot you. He hit with his carbine. I was looking for a clear line of sight when I found it. Hen's eye coordination says, he sounds a tiny bit sorry he did not find it before you got hit. I shot and wounded him, while Glenn took a bullet in the spine. It was meant for me. He did not survive. There's a pause. Oh, I was wondering why Glenn was hit and not Kim. Empathy says, this is not the first person to die in his place. He goes on. Titus, Fred Angus, and Theo charged. Angus and Theo did not make it. They both died before they made it to intensive care. Titus survives. So do Alan and the musician. I forget his name. Eugene? Yes, he's still alive, too. Nod. You were bleeding out. You said something. I don't know what. He thinks. And you warned me. I was able to disarm Officer DePaul before she got the jump on me. Esprit de Corps says, thank you. I killed her. The lieutenant takes a cigarette from his coat pocket and lights it. A bitter smell fills the room. And that's what happened. And they're all dead? All three of the contractors? He nods. DePaul was the last to die. Everett had their bodies returned to Krennel for a funeral. The company is yet to retaliate. Why? Because we deterred them? Or Joyce did? Maybe the harbor, in full lockdown? Is too costly a target. Or maybe... He breathes in the fume, thinking. Maybe they're simply taking their time and will attack soon? I don't know. So you also killed? He nods. I thought you only smoked one a day. This is the one. Makes sense. How many casualties on your union side? Total. 4. Glenn, Theo, Angus. The fat one, he took a lot of bullets. There's a pause. And Elizabeth, too. Elizabeth Beaufort was her name, the gardener. She did not make it? No. She bled out before Everett's surgeon could help her. Everett sent his personal doctor, but... He shakes his head. A costly loss for the Union. She was being trained for leadership. Yeah, she was like his lawyer or something. Or gave him legal advice, at least. If I would have presented the theory better to their leader... Well, that damages my morale. She never had a chance. She should not have been there in the first place. There was no way to convince them. Volition says, stop this line of thought now. You're too broken for ghosts. And that's... all. He nods. An absolute disaster. Yes, officer, he says calmly. 7 people are dead. It's not a success. But what's done is done. The violence is cordoned off. The hornets did not get into the beehive. He rubs his swollen chin. The worst scenario has not materialized. Yet. And, he smiles, we're still alive. Both of us. Rhetoric says he did not expect you both to survive once you had stepped between those two armies. Yeah, I was kind of wondering about that myself. Endurance says his smoking, his hunched back. You have it worse, but he took a real beating. That cigarette has medicinal properties. Ouch. It's not ouch time yet. You just got a Dramamine pill an hour ago. Wait until it wears off. Encyclopedia says, Dramamine. Then it's not that bad. Neither surgical nor organ damage bad, but still under-the-counter bad. The room. It's clean. Mr. Gart cleaned it. It took him an entire day. How long have I been out? 2 days, in and out. You've been up enough to take Dramamine and curse, and drink water. What did you say before? Sunrise? Sunrise Parabellum. Sunrise, prepare for war. It's an old revolutionary saying. My gun. It's engraved on it. It served you well. Is it war today? He looks out the window. The gates of the harbor are boarded up. The streets are a little more empty. Apocalyptic violence is yet to erupt, I am relieved to say. I think we may have held it off, for now. He unzips his bomber jacket. Barely.
A pity.
Good. Yes, we have also completely failed, but that's okay. How bad am I hurt? Pretty bad, officer. You suffered 2 wounds. The first is below your shoulder. The bullet passed through your shoulder blade, luckily missing your lung and heart. The second shot hit you in the thigh, the left quadriceps. He points to your leg. No major arteries were nicked, but the bullet had to be removed. A bacterial infection was treated with mercurochrome. Okay, I literally thought half of him was gone. Lucky he had no legs, no pelvis, just a torso, arms and head. Alright, so... But that was one of, that was our mind saying that, so it was wrong. I think that was pain threshold. So that... Can I walk? We will see. Savoir-faire says, you won't be able to dance much, that's for sure. You should be able to live with limping around now. Well, at least I got my dancing in while I could. Are you hurt? Not very, he rubs his chin. I have a concussion from that woman beating me with the butt of her gun. I try not to move too much. Things would be worse if you didn't warn me. There's a pause. Thank you. I did not see her coming. Stupid of me. But he was so concerned about Harry. Has anyone from my station been here to see me? No. Esprit de Corps says, a man and a woman sit in the front seat of an armored motor carriage. The woman is driving. The man lights a cigarette. Jean-Vic Mare is his name. The asphalt vanishes under the wheels of the machine. Ahead, harbor cranes rise to the sky. Back to that bleep hole, he says. Really? I called your station after the fight. The injury was logged in. They told me they've sent officers to join you on the site. Odd. You haven't seen any, have you? There's a pause. I'm sure they're worried about you. Redrick says, that means he hasn't seen them around while you were out. They're not really worried about you. If they were, wouldn't they be here? If they're so worried about me, where are they? I don't know. If not my station, then who treated me? I have a lot of questions. I did. I didn't know you could do that. It's part of a detective's task chain. You can do it too. Interfacing says, actually you can. You could even remove a fractured bullet, it seems. I do want to thank him. Treated me. Thank you. No need. Okay. Try to get up. Come on, Harry. You can do it, Harry. Come on. Easy now. The lieutenant turns double again before your eyes, an orange hue of pain. Savoir-faire says, your balance is way off. You feel like you're about to fall over on that thing. What thing? How are you? Gah. The lieutenant looks at you, teetering on your feet. What happens now, Kim? I honestly don't know. You don't know? We can't talk to Everard. The harbor is in lockdown. Everyone is in there is outside our grasp now. Joyce is left too, thanks to our meddling. You don't think it was a good idea? We know that. He doesn't think it's a good idea. Still left it up to us. I don't know what to think. It might not have been a bad idea. There is a pin somewhere in the machine. Something is keeping Krennel from sending in a death squad. He looks out the window. Maybe it's her? Maybe she kept her end. Either way, Ruby's gone. And Classier, too. We really should have arrested her, you know. Wait, you've checked? She's really... Gart confirms she left 20 minutes prior to the tribunal showing up. So she knew it was coming. Who did it then, Kim? Who killed the hangman? I don't know. I think the dangerous theory you presented on Classier, or whatever her name is, was wrong. We have not found a motive or a weapon for her. Honestly, I think our investigation has not produced a single credible suspect. His voice is calm, matter-of-factly. Flowers? Is that evidence? This is because I'm La Puta Madre's peon, isn't it? Don't be narcissistic. Half the cops in Revachol West are his peons. Even if you are, it's not a decisive factor in this case. Logic says that does make some sense. The goddamn footprints. Yes, he says. God cursed the footprints, not solving the case for us. Oh, diablo. Devil? There's still a 28% possibility the shot came from a distance. We should go upstairs. Rethink the ballistics in situ. A light nod through some pain. I agree with this. What else? An antique bullet from a Bell McGrave, 44.6 millimeters. How hard can it be to find one? How hard can it be? It's extremely easy. There are thousands lying around. We found one. All completely unusable. It's precisely how easy it is to find one that makes the bullet useless. Well, there are all these old bunkers and weapon caches. Revolutionary era? We could find thousands more if we wanted. All of Revachol is full of them. Inland Empire says, but they seem so mysterious. I can't believe they're useless. No need to be melodramatic. Tell my drama that. The Maybells? Oh, I don't know what I'm talking about here. The flowers. Maybe this will jog my memory. The Maybells came. The flowers. What? They were on the roof. I did not catch them. Butterfingers. Oh, the thing was flying away. Every piece of garbage in the city is not connected to the case. You don't have to catch everything. Rhetoric says he's wrong. This is a stupid thing to say. Okay. You know what I think about solving crimes? He arches his brow. The ceiling fan patiently spins overhead. Don't mess with me, ceiling fan. I have bad history with ceiling fans. Solving crimes is hard, almost impossible, super easy. Solving crimes is not almost impossible, but hard. It really is very hard. Pain Threshold says that concussion must be making him dizzy. You're not ready to give up, are you? No. There's a short pause. Are you ready to limp? I'm ready. Good. There's a pause. Where do you want to limp? Logic says, the lieutenant did mention doing more ballistics. Pain Threshold says, also, it's just close enough to endure the walk. I don't know. Aimlessly wander. Okay, let's check Mrs. Katarzyne Alessi's room upstairs. I wish it told me how to say that name, too. I know how to say Classier. Why not? He extinguishes the cigarette on the sole of his boot. New task. Another look at the window, perhaps? The one he was shot through. I don't know. I can't think of anything better. Okay, so I got 2 skill points. And I got this. Inspect the window in Classier's bedroom. Go to her room. Search it once more. Upstairs in the bedroom. The window. Perhaps it will yield something. Alright. The bed's a little nicer now. You could get a good night's sleep here. No time to rest yet. Oh, is this his actual room? I don't recognize it looking normal. Newly replaced glass, shining in the morning light. You hear traffic outside. Back in the world again. I really thought the game was over. The ceiling fan stands still. The lights are off again. The lights are on. The switch must be broken because nothing happens. The air in the room is starting to feel like vaporized urine. Really? The Stereo 8 player has been reunited with its right speaker. Maybe put the gun away so I'm not running around with a gun. That would alarm people, wouldn't it? You see gleaming white enamel. No bottles inside. Look, the door is open. You can walk right into Kim's room. Oh. Okay. Anything new here? That's locked still. The bathroom mirror has been wiped completely clean. You see the reflection of your face in the mirror, such as is a regular clean-shaven police officer. Is he gonna mind? The alarm is set for 6:50 a.m. Medicinal supplies on the cupboard. Mercurochrome, a scalpel, antibiotics. What's this? These papers bear the stamp of the RCM. They appear to be fragments of the lieutenant's paperwork, half finished. You make out notes on this and other recent cases. I had Gart open the door to your room. He closes the notes. You were running a low bacterial fever the first night. Thank you for keeping this thing alive a little longer. It wouldn't have been easy were it not for my concussion. We both got lucky, considering the odds we faced. There's a pause. Let's go. I am sure neither of us feels solid enough to keep loitering in this room. Let's go. Okay. That's solid enough. Could we not go out this way? I can't open that door. Why not? Wait. Ouch, that leg hurts. Maybe if you don't run, it'll be okay. Am I supposed to not run now? Looks like she's left something on the table. She has indeed. Farewell note? Next to stacks of bills, you see a note. A few lines jotted down in large, uneven handwriting just as the writer was about to rush out the door. You know what? I can get the music going again. Probably missed a unique tune. Oh well. I'm sorry I screwed everyone over. P.S. I didn't kill him. P.P.S. Gift upstairs. A gift? The lieutenant turns to the staircase suspiciously, looking for any signs of another presence in the shadows above. Well, it could be true. The shot could have been meant for her. But then the person had a chance to shoot again. Without knowing where the person was, since it's so hard to figure it out. Unless they only had one bullet, or their gun jammed or something like that. The former would be very stupid. What could this gift be? I am not drawing my gun yet, but I don't like gifts. Hand-eye coordination says he's not, but his hand moves instinctively towards his holster as he studies the note. Seems like she left in a hurry. It's hardly surprising. Alright, let's check in here. Oh, running, sorry. Check in here again. The medicine cabinet is empty, not even a toothbrush. Electrochemistry says, pity. She's really cleaned this out. The lieutenant nods. She certainly had her priorities straight when she was packing. The gift, meaning I hope it was drugs? No, let's not say that. Yeah. All right. Not running. A red thread made of nylon. It leads out of the room and onto the roof. That's the gift. She's showing us the trajectory of the gun. Really? You see the same two neon-lit shapes, a man and a woman, only now a red thread bisects the room, pointing from the antenna outside to the cupboard on the wall. This is ballistics. She's left a trajectory for us. The lieutenant tests the thread with his finger. Drawn taut, it rebounds instantly. A ray of backward motion explodes from his mouth to the roof outside. A prime, to then widen into a radius of locations in Martinet's. B prime, B double prime, and B triple prime. Where does the thread lead? It suggests the bullet came from the extreme upper quadrant of possible angles, from a point beyond the roof, B. So is this to that island, then? The island in the bay. Is she trying to tell us the shot came from the islet? Kim nods. Unless she thinks the perpetrator was standing on the ring antenna, that is where the thread seems to point. There are ruins on that islet. A sunken Seaford. I saw it through the coin-operated viewer. The lieutenant looks out the window and onto the bay. How did she know how to do this? She was there that night. She would have known precisely where the bullet hole was in the glass. Visual calculus says she had a long time to think about it after, standing on that roof, staring at the glass. It also looks like there may be more to her skill set than we know. The question is, should we trust her? I just don't know. Indeed, neither do I. This is also the only point of origin we haven't ruled out yet. So it is. Empathy says, for a second he seems tired. You seem unenthusiastic. I just haven't gotten a lot of sleep these past few days. Empathy says he doesn't really believe this will yield anything. Maybe we should go to the island? The wind blows in from the open window. The lieutenant sighs, looking into the cold distance across the water. I'm going to the island. Are you in? Of course, he nods. Of course I'm in. He takes a second to gather himself, then says, how do we get there? Joyce Messier had her sloop, but she's gone. Lillian, the net picker. She's tarring her boat. Ah, yes, of course. The village. Let's go. Go to the island. Go to the islet in the bay. There could be a boat in the fishing village on the coast. Ask there. All right, let's walk out here first. The thread is tied to the antenna. And that's it for that. What's that? There's a tiny hole in the wall. You see a bedroom on the other side. Really? I didn't see this before. Electrochemistry says you can almost see the shape of a man and a woman writhing inside, bathed in drug sweat and dirty linens. Bottles lie around everywhere. I think it could see into Classier's bedroom from here. Kim leans closer to inspect the peephole. You can barely see through. Better not jump to sensationalist conclusions here. The footprints on the floor, however. He points to the marks nearby on the floor. Definitely suspicious. What were those people doing in there? You lean closer to the peephole, instinctively. I bet they're doing something quite unnatural there. Sensationally unnatural. Well, they were having sex and doing drugs. I mean, what else? I got 3 skill points. You know what I'm gonna do, since I have 3 skill points? Clear out my thought cabinet. The motorway south is almost done. Alright, plus 2 perception. I like having that. Endurance and volition. That's good. Learning cap for endurance raised to 4. So if I undo this, will endurance go down? So maybe not. Wumpty Dumpty Dom Center. Oh, this I love. It's giving me money and stuff. All intellect learning caps raised by one. Or maybe I'll just wait until this is done. Because we got 7 minutes. Anything new about the footprints? Jackpot. These, unlike everything else here, are new. I wasn't up here by myself, right? You've seen all this. Oh. Large prints, most likely made by boots. These are new. The size is hard to determine. Sole could be bigger than vamp. The soles have left a pattern, uniform horizontal lines. This print doesn't look like the odd-soled print we found at the hanging, Kim. He inspects the tracks closer. The size looks about the same, actually. They're not the same shoe, but they could be the same person. This doesn't look like the worker's boots from the hanging, does it? No, these little horizontal lines are different. They look custom-made to me, or some kind of foreign print. Hard to say. Still a boot, though. Alright. See if we find something else since we found that. Told us not to run. Nothing else up here. Interfacing says, all these mesmerizing machines just waiting to be plugged back in and played. Run your finger across the dust of the white Diora machine. Feels like it might jump back to life any moment, the lights illuminating the white-robed woman. What's white Diora? Some kind of, Kim looks around thinking, inane pinball theme. Probably related to Messina during the DeLorean age. The history themes are the worst. Empathy says, Lieutenant grimaces, looking at the machines. See, it sounds like you don't enjoy pinball, Kim. No, I love it. I love pinball. Who doesn't love pinball? Let's move on. Trauma says he doesn't. How about we fire one of these bad boys up and play some ball? You can't fire them up. They're broken. Only that machine in the main hall works, the Royalist pinball. He looks away. Half-Life says, what a dumb name, Royalist pinball. If they weren't broken, he would kick one of those machines about now. Kim Katsuragi. Oh, what about that other one, the Franco-Nigerian ball? Want to play that? No. Breakthrough imminent. High for thinking Kim Katsuragi? Kim Pinball Katsuragi. A.K.A. Kimball? Encyclopedia says exactly. That's what he's known as. His reputation precedes him. Oh, you have a past in pinball. Hey, Kimball. What? You're Kim Pinball Katsuragi. So now he remembers. He looks at you in the silence of the workshop, then takes his glasses off and cleans them. So another thing I've forgotten? Fine, I'm Kim Pinball Katsuragi. He puts them back on, a.k.a. the Kimball. You remembered. Congratulations. Wait, but I still can't remember anything else. Wonderful. He only remembers hearing about the pinball policeman. You don't seem to really like pinball. No human being should. It's a game that requires no skill and a childlike affinity to flashing lights and to fantastique science fiction and historic romance franchises. It is lame. Then why are you called Pinball? I am not called Pinball. It was used to taunt me a long time ago, before I became a homicide detective and got my lieutenancy. How did you... He puts his glasses back on. Fine, I was a juvenile police officer for over 15 years. It's how I started out in the RCM. Once I had to infiltrate a pinball ring, as you do. As you do when you're a juvie cop. Okay? It was not okay. I needed to become a pinball champion. He shudders. I trained for 9 months. The job was successful, and I was moved out of the juvenile wing to homicide. End of story. You were a juvie cop for 15 years? That time is over now. He looks at the pinball machine and breathes in. I was already a 38-year-old man, It was unbecoming, as was playing pinball. Empathy says, so that's why he doesn't want to talk to Kuno. Trauma and stressor disorder from being a juvie cop. This would be cruel to do. Both of these. These are nice. Wait, so that's why you didn't talk to Kuno. It's best if you handle the juvenile delinquents, he nods. Don't worry, I'll keep calling you, Kim. Lieutenant Kitsuragi is good, too, he nods. Now, we really need to continue our sweep of what appears to be a secret path through the whirling. Yeah, we're done with that, actually. Thought complete. Motorway south. What do we got? The lone vector stretches in your mind's eye into the wild pale yonder for an unimaginable distance, forgetting, until you can no longer remember anything. No cities, no mountains, no oceans, and finally, no vector. Nothing remains, a blank space with no point of reference, where only one type of motion is possible. The motion of a human throat swallowing. And then it comes to you. To reach the end of the motorway south is to be unborn. You've had this thought before while aimlessly wandering the streets of Jamrock, a lost piece of the man you were, a dark hope. All intellect white checks unlocked, plus one Inland Empire for the swallowing motion. The backyard wall. And the mirror. What the hell with the mirror? I do want to check out that wall. That's it. We can check out the wall again. And then I'll probably forget the thought and go for another one. Alright. Everything looks same. Hello, Gart.
Oh, you're up. It's good to see you back on your feet. Did you like your room? I cleaned it for you.